Storm Team 8, your most accurate meteorologist using the most advanced radar. Live Super Doppler HD, keeping you safe under an umbrella protection.
Welcome back, everyone. School night for scouting. It kicks off tonight, 7 o'clock, your local elementary school. You can stop by and get the kids registered. And some of the fun stuff they do is like this, the marshmallow crossbow. And guys, even though this is a toy crossbow, you need to treat it like a real one, okay? So before you put your finger on the trigger, see how my finger's out straight like that? That way I can't get into trouble and accidentally hit anybody with this. And we always want to make sure it's unloaded when we pick it up. So see that? Empty? Okay, we're going to put a marshmallow in here now. And we'll close, and we'll lock it, okay? You hold that for me. All right, finger's still straight, and we don't have anybody out in front of us that we're gonna hurt if this thing goes off, all right? So we're gonna cock it. Are we clear? Clear to the left, clear to the right. All right, we ready to fire? Whoa! That rabbit's not in good shape. It's eating the marshmallow now. All right. Fictitious rabbit. Let's talk a little bit about what's going on weather-wise, and we have a beautiful evening outside, so send the scouts out, get them signed up for this year's activities. Temperatures out there, 70 degrees, 56 the dew point, 61% southeast winds, and the pressure is steady, just high clouds. Those are the leftover remnants of Hermine. Winter set time lapse today as we roll it on into motion. You'll see the clouds moving in, but we did not get the low-level moisture to produce any rain, just the upper-level moisture, which produce the clouds and kind of cool things off a little bit this afternoon. Highs today were warmest to the south, coolest to the north, the cloud cover keeping temperatures here in the metro at about 73 degrees. Satellite and radar, you can watch the rain, the remnants of that tropical system, which last night produced severe weather in Texas, moving across Oklahoma, Missouri, and on into southern Illinois. A little bit of that moisture still may impact us, but really the rain we're going to see tomorrow as we look at the surface features will be a front which will be approaching from the west. And as that slides into the state late afternoon and into the evening hours, the chances for rain will increase. Now the timing on this looks pretty good for football. We'll have some scattered clouds and maybe a light shower Friday evening, but by Saturday most of the rain will be through. Let's look at the timeline tonight. Just some clouds, maybe some sprinkles south. Friday, we really don't generate much in the way of rain until late in the evening, and you can see by early Saturday morning, the rain already pushing into eastern Iowa, and it looks like by mid-morning Saturday, the rain will all be east of us, and we'll have a pretty good weather forecast for the game in Iowa City. All right, forecast-wise for tonight, here's the way things are shaping up. High clouds and 60 degrees, southeast winds at about 10 during the day tomorrow. Clouds will continue to be over, so we'll have an occasional shower, but the best chances will hold off until Friday evening and into the overnight, and temperatures will be cooler with the cloud cover. On Saturday, temperatures will recover into the mid-70s with a chance for some early morning showers, but game day forecast looks dry, 80 on Sunday, and rain chances start creeping back in again on Monday and on Tuesday. So kind of a cool day tomorrow, but overall pretty good weather, and it's a beautiful night out here now, and when we come back, we'll load up a couple of these and let you guys try your hand, all right? Sure. Okay, school night for scouting, 7 o'clock. Don't forget it. Back with more out here in a bit.
John, you can shoot those marshmallows right into our...